Hello guys, welcome to my statistics class. We already discussed in the previous class what are the methods we have to find standard deviation. Now I am going to solve some few problems based on that. The first problem, the first example is, suppose data having like a 6, 7, 10, 11, 13, 16, 18, 25. Yeah, I want to find out standard deviation, variance and quotient of variation. Now if you want to find out standard deviation, variance and quotient of variation, in all the cases are required a mean. Is there any small data only having a values of the variables? How to find out the mean? X bar is equal to sum of the values divided by number of values. Take sum 6 plus 7 plus 10 plus 7, 11 plus 11 like that. We have to take that sum. That sum is given as 117 divided by number of values. How many values we have? 9 values. That given as actually 13. Yeah, 13 is a whole number. 13 is a whole number. Now I'll skip that how to find it because everyone is familiar with my all previous video. You already listened means you know how to find out the mean. Therefore, this is a whole number. Once you get a whole number, there are two formula to find out standard deviation. One formula, square root of sigma xi minus x bar whole square divided by n. What's the alternative formula for sigma is sigma xi square divided by n minus of sigma xi divided by n whole square. This is alternative formula. Either you go for this formula, this choice of you. Here is a whole number. If I am going to solve by using first formula. The first, if you want to go for first formula, first I have to take xi. 6, 7, 10, 11. Again, they are having another one, 11, 13, 16, 18 and 25. Yes. Next, I have to find out what's the total you already have on the board, 117. You already calculated whatever the standard deviation. Therefore, what's the thing here? First, you have to take the difference of xi minus x bar. This is the first problem. Then, I am going to write everything on the board. I am going to explain very detail on the board. Okay? Xi minus x bar. 6 minus 13. What is 6 minus 13? Is minus 7. 7 minus 13. What we get actually? Minus 6. 10 minus 13. Minus 13. 11 minus 13 is what? Minus 2. Again, 11 minus 13 is minus 2. 13 minus 13 is 0. 16 minus, 13 is 3. 18 minus 13 is 5. What is 25 minus 13 is 12. Yeah. I don't want this this sum. I told very clearly, once you take this sum, definitely we get 0 from the first property of mean. Here, we are finding square of that. That's why not necessary to find out absolute value. Once we get negative or positive, what is square of that is positive only. What is minus 7 whole square? 49. And next, what is 6 minus 6 whole square? 36. Minus 6 whole square? 9. Minus 2 whole square? 4. Minus 2 whole square? 4. 0. 3 square? 9. 5 square is 25. 12 square is 144. Yeah. You take this total, we get 280. 280 is my total. Now based on that, we are going to calculate what is my standard deviation. What is the standard deviation formula? We are going to use first formula. Sigma xi minus x bar. What is sigma xi? 280. Divided by number of values. What is number of values here? 9. 280 by 9. That is actually... whatever that sigma value is approximately 2 decimal 31.11. So this implies what is sigma square is nothing but actually 280 divided by 9. 280 divided by 9 is variance. Sigma is nothing but 31.11. Square of that is nothing but whatever variance. How to find out CV for this? Standard quotient of variation is nothing but sigma by x bar into 100. What is sigma? Value 31.11 divided by x bar is 13 into 100. You calculate it, you write what's the value approximately in 2 decimal or 4 or 5. Final answer, I am going to request everyone better or write it in the form of 5 decimal value. Then only we get more accuracy. Okay? Now I think is everyone is clear? how to find out the standard deviation based on values of the variables. Here I taken direct method. I explain why I consider direct method. If we want to find out alternative method, sigma xi square by n minus of sigma xi by n whole square. Here also we get same answer because mean is an exact value here. The next, I'm moving to the next step. Is suppose the given data in the form of frequency. I'm not going to write the problem separately. I'm going to write first to column. I'm considering discrete frequency distribution. Is nothing but 3. The corresponding frequency is 7, 8, 10, 13, 15, 18, 10, and then 23 is nothing but 6. This is my whatever the data in the form of discrete frequency distribution. Now here, if you want to go for whatever that step deviation method, whatever maybe, I am going to do it direct method because it's a very simple value. Observe xi value x 3, 8, 13, 18, 23 is not a huge value. Therefore, what I am going to do here, I am going to find out directly fi xi because here the formula for finding a standard deviation is square root of r clear. I am not going to use this direct formula. I am going to use alternative formula sigma fi xi square divided by fi minus of sigma fi xi divided by sigma fi whole square. I am going to use alternative formula. I want to show it how we have to find out. Yes. Now, what is fi xi first value here? Now, here I required what fi xi value and also required which value now? Another column is fi xi square. I don't want more than that. Now, here 7, 3 into 7 is what actually? 21. Are you clear? And then 8 into 10 is 80. And next 13 into 15 we get 195. 10 into 18 is 180, 23 into 6 will we get 138. I want to reverse the total of sigma fi. The total of sigma fi is 48. The total of fi xi is nothing but 614. I want to find out fi xi square. Anyway, we have fi xi is 21 into again into 3. 21 into again into 3 we get 63. 8 into 8 we get 640. Yes? Fi xi into xi is nothing but fi x 195 into 13. 195 into 13 we get 2535. 180 into 18 is nothing but 320 3240, because we have 0. And then 138 into 23 that gives rise 3174. Immediately is possible, I have to correct. You do one thing, if you want to save a time, anyway you have to calculate fi xi, 3 into 7. You substitute immediately to take this next value. Again, you multiply this value with 3 in the calculator. Immediately you have to substitute simultaneously both the values. Then you have to avoid the time saving now here. And then you multiply 8 into 10. You substitute here, again multiply 8, immediately you get the simultaneously is possible, I have to calculate that. Another one point you have to know that. Now in the statistics I required much time, how to reduce time in within short time, how to find out our required solution, this is a technique I have to know that. Now 13 into 15 I have to multiply, substitute here, again multiply 13, we get this. Simultaneously is possible, I have to calculate third column and fourth column. Once we get this value, this total is 9652. Next I have to substitute this. Now we have to calculate sigma must be equal to square root of sigma fi xi is 9652 divided by 48 minus of 614 divided by 48 whole square. You simplify that, we get approximately 6.21202. And then square of the sigma square is nothing but 12.79167. Just you take the square of this. And then, or another way, just you take the difference, you write a sigma square, square root of that is nothing but our sigma value. C, quotient of variation is nothing but sigma by 100, sigma by x bar into 100. Now sigma is nothing but what actually? 6.1202 divided by x bar. Now x bar, you know how to calculate. Suppose you are not calculate x bar, so you anyway have f by xi. What is f by xi value? 614 divided by 48 to calculate. And then simplify that, we get approximately into 100. This multiplied with what? 100. That gives 47%. 0.83%. This is a way to calculate. Suppose the given data in the form of discrete frequency distribution, or maybe continuous also, just try to find out bit value. Yeah, how to calculate by using alternative formula. Are you clear? Now, this is a way to find out by using alternative formula. Otherwise, you go for direct formula. But the thing is, first you find out the mean. Suppose it's exact value, find out. Otherwise, it's not exact value. It's not easy to calculate. Yes, next I'm going to explain how to solve the problem in the continuous random variable distribution. Here, I'm not going to solve that problem, entire problem on the board. Just I'll give a trick. You try and do it. Because everything I'll do it on the board, there is no thinking power in your mind how to do it. Better that I'm going to give how to solve the problem for continuous frequency distribution. Now the value for continuous is here class and corresponding frequencies. The class is 30 to 40, the value is 3 frequency value. 40 to 50, the value is 7. 50 to 60, the value is nothing but 12. 60 to 70, the value is nothing but 15. Like that, 60 to 70 is over 70 to 80. The value is corresponding value is nothing but 8. 80 to 90, the corresponding frequency value is 3. 90 to 100 is 2. This is the data they provide. This is an exclusive class. Just I'll give a hint how to proceed. You find do it and try for that. See, the first is take the class and then frequency, and then you find out what actually mid value. Because it's a classes, you know how to find out mid value. You find out. After you find out, if you want to proceed by using finding a mean, or finding a mean is for if you want to find out a mean. If you want to go for state deviation method or whatever may be, or just you calculate direct fi xi, you calculate it. X bar is nothing but fi sigma fi xi by x bar. And then if suppose you are very familiar, you have an interest in fi into xi minus x bar, goes for you calculate, divided by total frequency, square root of that is nothing but standard deviation, you know that. But the thing is, that mean must be a what actually? Whole number. Suppose mean is not a whole number, better to go for alternative formula. After fx, you find out fx. But anyway, while doing a calculation, you are using a calculator, better to go for alternative formula. Using this, you try to calculate this. No need to do it on the board. Just similar to the discrete frequency distribution. Thank you. See, observe carefully. Once again, I'm going to inform. This is a method. Taking addition and to compare more than one set of data, which one is more reliable, which one is more consistent, they are going to use when in the factory or maybe are using to in the taking addition for the cricket player, whatever may be. Or if we want to take who is more reliable to compare the student's marks also, we are going to use that. Are you clear? I think if we want type of problem, I'll come and do it in my next class. How to compare to take which one is more reliable, more consistent. I have already given here hint. You go through that any textbook, easy to understand. Otherwise, within 10 minutes, within 5 minutes, I'm going to solve one problem. After that, I'm going to explain protosis and quartile deviation. This is a part of which one measure, another category part of measure of dispersion. Thank you very much for listening my talk. Yes. Okay.